society, we have different groups, and people gravitate to that. And in jail, because you need to build a family, people will segregate themselves to survive, basically.
Your freedom has already been taken away. So being able to relate to a group of girls that you can say, I'm used to rice and beans, or I'm used to collard greens, you can feel comfort, you feel safe.
I'm black, she's black, and she's black, and we like fried chicken. Chicken for the people.
I think the most important things that these groups provide for people is familiarity. I think they provide protection. I think they provide an understanding, cultural understanding.
You build a family and you build trust with these groups. But within there does cause tension, which creates an interesting show.
I never set out to make Oz. It wasn't men's prison, it was women's prison. And there's a great history of shows about women's prison, and we wanted to just put our spin on it.
The first day that I was in prison, I experienced this phenomenon of the welcome wagon, in which prisoners step forward to help someone who is brand new in prison navigate and literally give them the shampoo or the toothpaste that they need, because the prison certainly will not provide it.
There's some tissues. That's nice, always had. And a toothbrush. They don't give you one.
And that is organized along racial lines, at least in the prisons that I was held in.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you for everything.
Aww. No, it's no problem. We look out for our own.
Our own?
Oh, don't get all PC on me. It's tribal, not racist.
Arriving in a place where things are incredibly volatile and potentially violent, you want to learn how to be in a secure place quickly, and maybe that's what we do. We look to people who look like us, who sound like us, and we make that our first decision.
Okay, go sit there. She's a nice white lady.
Thanks.
For me, this show is really about women and women of different ages, races, body types, all sort of cohabitating together. It's interesting to think of prison as this place where all this diversity can and does exist.
There's like a tribal system, so there's the white girls are kind of live in the suburbs.
There's the ghetto dorms, which are the black women, and then you have Spanish Harlem, which are the Hispanics. And then you have other, which is everybody else.
The social relationships in prison are deeply important, and that's how people survive. It matters who you're friends with, and it matters who you're not friends with.
Look, just pretend it's the 1950s. It makes it easier to understand.
Then there's like a bunch of different Caucasian groups, and some of them are more religious, and it's very cliquey. It's like high school, except a little more dangerous.
Did you vote for her?
No.
Did you vote for her? Who voted for that bitch? Raise your hand. Raise it.
Lorna says in the first episode, it's tribal, not racist. She says it in a slightly different accent.
And it really is. It's just people holding as closely to what they know from the outside as possible. I think that's what it really provides, a sense of home.
All these women put on this tough front because they have to like protect themselves, but underneath there's all this other stuff going on. But having this, you know, support group is extremely important for them.
It'll be okay, sister. There's always hope tomorrow will be taco night.
Tomorrow's beef and noodles.
There is this structure to it, and I feel that it's not necessarily to segregate. I think it's actually more to unify.
Come sit with us, not with crazy eyes.
We went to Chino, a women's facility in Chino, with all the writers. I was speaking with the assistant warden who had worked in a men's prison, and I said, what's the difference here? And he said, men are out for themselves and women are communal. They form families, they share. And I thought that was just a really interesting difference.
All of us in the kitchen making tamales. Almost feels like Christmas at home.
I think women in general, we are more nurturing. And what we are discovering more in season one is how people just build families. It's about survival, and it's about making sure that you're with your own people.
Ya tú sabes.
Who are you?
Her daughter.
Who are you?
Her daughter.
What I found when I was incarcerated is that the things that we have in common are much more important than the things that are divisive.
Ven, mami, tú no estás sola.
All prisoners miss their freedom. All mothers in prison miss their children. Race is an important defining factor, but it's not the only defining factor. And people definitely forge very deep and meaningful friendships across racial lines.
There's definitely times, for example, in the episode where Trisha dies, we all get together.
Thank you.
I'm really sorry for your loss.
Yeah, gracias.
I think there's definitely times when events happen that are heavy enough that affect all of us enough that, like, nobody's looking at that kind of a thing anymore.
She gotta pour one out for her, right?
Thanks, son.
Yeah.
I think that being able to relate in the sense that we're all locked up, but we're all accepting each other, that allows every woman in prison to fight for that same reason. I'm a woman, I'm a human, I have the right to be treated as a human, regardless of why I'm in here or not.
Got my visitation revoked because of you? What'd you get? Should've fucking known.
Different people fared very differently in the criminal justice system because of racism and classism, and those things I think are really front and center in the show.
There's a lot of depth to all our roles, so I think that it's an interesting thing that while sort of playing potential stereotypes, we also get to crush them. I think it's gonna be interesting to see what other relationships strike up.
I'm proud to turn on the TV and see 100 different women on the screen of every age and every color and every race. I have not seen that before. And to be able to tell all their stories is a privilege, and I feel really proud of that, that we put all these amazing ladies up there and get to tell their stories. They're criminals, but, but they're amazing.